Did you know that trees are one of the most powerful tools in the fight against climate change? As climate change continues to rise, Earth's temperatures, our weather is becoming more extreme and unpredictable, causing big changes worldwide. Polar ice caps melting, wildfires, hurricanes, drought, extreme heat, and cold. Big reductions in carbon pollution will help fight further climate changes. Planting trees is one way to reduce carbon pollution. Climate changes have damaged the ability of forests to grow back on their own. Planting millions of new trees will not only help existing trees and forests, it will also clean the air and reduce greenhouse gases and pollution. In cities, trees help cool communities and provide shade. They offer habitats for wildlife. When communities suffer from the lack of trees or their destruction, people suffer too. Women, people of color, people living in poverty, and marginalized individuals such as indigenous people suffer the most. So, how do trees relate to watersheds? In this activity, you're going to learn about watersheds. A watershed can be a very small area that drains into a local pond or stream. Think of the creek behind your house or the pond down the road. Water has drained into small bodies by covering the land areas beneath. Watersheds are made up of vegetation, trees, grass, or shrubs. Tree roots protect watersheds by shielding the soil from erosion. Trees also provide a canopy of shade to keep the water cool. Despite their differences in size, all watersheds share the same goal, to transfer water over the Earth's surface, which in turn helps to preserve trees. This activity will take approximately 45 minutes and can be completed outside, in a kitchen, or at a table. You will need one large baking pan. I am using two for easy cleanup. Some newspaper. In this case, I'm recycling old construction paper. Masking tape. A white plastic garbage bag. You could also use wax paper or a plastic grocery storage bag. A spray bottle or watering can. And blue food coloring. You can work in groups or individually to make your watershed model. Let's get started. Crumple up your paper into several large and small balls. These balls will represent the shapes of your mountains, peaks, and ridges. Place your papers in the pan and use tape to hold them down. Your pan should look something like this. Drape the plastic garbage bag over the paper balls. The plastic cover is Earth's surface. Fill your watering can or spray bottle with water and blue food coloring. Spray or pour over your model to see how the water behaves. Where does the water flow? Do you see low points filled with water that might represent lakes and rivers? Once you have finished, think about these questions. What was it like simulating a watershed? Trees and watersheds have a direct link. One can't survive without the other. In what ways are they important to each other? How does deforestation affect your life and the lives of others?